The sun is a raging inferno of nuclear reactions. In fact, it releases as much energy as 10 billion nuclear weapons going off every second. We bathe in the light of nuclear reactions, which is pretty crazy. And these nuclear reactions, just like the ones that have happened on Earth, release radiation. Torrents of radiation rush towards the Earth. And this radiation is dangerous. It can cause cancer. Luckily, we have a trick up our sleeve. Just like in a science fiction movie, our Earth has a shield made of magnetic fields. It turns out this shield bends those radioactive particles around the Earth and protects us and preserves our very lives. Let's take a look at this magnetic shield. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce the Earth's shield, which protects us from this onslaught of radiation. Then we'll learn the right-hand rule for the magnetic force. Basically, the right-hand rule will tell us what direction the magnetic force is going to be in. And then we'll apply the right-hand rule to the Earth's shield so that we can actually see the direction of the magnetic force. All right, strange as it seems, this is a real video of a phenomenon known as the Northern Lights. Perhaps you've heard of it. It's also called the Aurora Borealis. What we're seeing here is the direct impact of the Earth's magnetic shield and all the solar radiation flying towards the Earth. How does this work? Well, let's take a look at our Earth shield. Here is our magnetic field. Recall that the north magnetic pole is on the south side of the Earth, and the south magnetic pole is on the north side, which is a little confusing, but that magnetic field bends from the bottom of the Earth to the top, and it serves to protect us. How does that work? Here is the sun and the Earth. The Earth's magnetic field protects it from the solar wind that's full of radiation from the sun. The solar wind is full of charged particles. That's the radioactive material, represented here in green. This barrage of radiation is bent around the Earth by the magnetic field, keeping us safe. Notice some of those green particles collect on the tops and bottoms of the Earth. That's what's responsible for this light show, which can be seen as you move towards the North or South Pole. What you see here isn't directly the radiation. Instead, you're seeing the light made by the collisions between charged particles and the atmosphere. Sadly, though, not every planet or planetoid has this magnetic shield. The moon, for example, lacks the magnetic shield. And because of that, the moon is exposed to 150 times more radiation. That much more radiation would lead to more cancer and more cell death. So radiation is really bad for life. That may be one reason Mars is lifeless. Mars doesn't have a magnetic field. And without the magnetic field, life is much less likely. When we compare the surface of Mars, it's barren and lifeless, and the surface of Earth is teeming with life. There are many reasons for this difference, but one that helps support the life of Earth is our magnetic shield. Here we have the magnetic shield shown once again schematically. There's a force on each charged particles, remember, that bends them around the Earth. Magnetic fields exert a force on moving charges. There's a lot going on there. First, we have magnetic fields. In this specific example, the magnetic field of the Earth. And it exerts a force, a pushing or pulling, on the moving charges. And these charges are that solar wind. Importantly, these charges must be moving for there to be a force. Here's a question. What direction is the force? Well, if we want to know the direction of the force, we use something called the right-hand rule. Here you have it, a picture or a schematic of a right hand. What I want you to do is hold your right hand up. Point your thumb straight up like you're giving a thumbs up. Then point your finger straight ahead of you. It makes kind of like a gun, like when you were a kid. And then point your middle finger out to the left. Now you're holding your hand in the perfect position to do the right hand rule. Your pointer finger is always going to point towards the direction of the charges. Your middle finger will always point in the direction of the magnetic field. When you do that, your thumb will tell you the direction of the force. All right, we're going to walk through using this right-hand rule a couple times. Let's take a look at an example where we have charges moving from the top of the screen to the bottom. Step one in using your right-hand rule is point your finger, your pointer finger, in the direction of the charges. Okay, Now, just remember, use your right hand. If you use your left hand, you'll get the opposite and wrong answer. So make sure you're using your right hand. And what should be happening now is your pointer finger should be pointing down. Now let me show you the magnetic field it's moving towards. It's moving from left to right. So now we take our middle finger, and it's going to be moving towards the right side of the screen. So our pointer finger's pointing down, and then our middle finger's pointing out towards the right. Our thumb is now pointing in the direction of the force. And that means the force is coming out of the screen. If you're holding your hand correctly, your thumb is pointing towards you, your pointer finger is pointing down, and your middle finger is pointing to the right. Let's try one more example. Here, all we've done is switch the direction of the charges. Now they're going up the screen. And we want to, again, figure out the direction of the force on those charges. Remember, this is the direction that the charges are going to be pushed, okay? That's what a force does. First up, take your pointer finger and point it in the direction of the charge. Okay, the charges are going up the screen, so you should take your right hand and it's going to be pointing straight up. Now let your middle finger point in the direction of the magnetic field. This is probably going to cause you to rotate your hand out towards the right, and your middle finger should be pointing to the right. Now your thumb is pointing in the direction of the force. It should be pointing towards the screen if you're doing this correctly. Okay. So hopefully you're tracking along with this right hand rule. If you're still confused, I would recommend rewinding and watching the last 3 or 4 minutes. All right, here we have the magnetic field of the Earth, and charges come straight at the magnetic field. We're going to now use the right hand rule to determine what direction is force. What direction is the magnetic field of the Earth going to push on these charges? Pause the video and see if you can figure out the direction of the force. All right, were you able to get it? Again, take your pointer finger, point it in the direction of charges. So it's going to be pointing towards the right, and it's going to be pointing towards the Earth. Now take your middle finger, and it needs to point up the direction of the magnetic field. Then your thumb should be pointing away from the screen, and that's the direction of the force, out of the screen. Again, if you're struggling with this right-hand rule, just repeat the last 5 minutes a few times and practice a couple times, and you'll get it down. Let's review what we've learned. First, we introduced the Earth's shield. We saw that the Earth's magnetic field can protect it from charged particles. Then we learned the right-hand rule for magnetic force. We saw that if you take your pointer finger and put it in the direction of the charges, your middle finger and point it in the direction of the magnetic field, then your thumb points in the direction of the force, the direction that those charges are pushed on. Then we applied the right-hand rule to the Earth's shield. Hey, hey.